Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. You know, there's an amazing thing going on right now. I just read from an apostolic conservative blog where he says, okay, the Bible's full of errors. It's got all kinds of errors in it. But we're not arguing for the perfection of the Bible. We're arguing that Jesus Christ rose from the dead 2,000 years ago. Now, in case you don't know your history, this has been tried before. In the 20s, modernists tried that, and it doesn't work. I mean, you can't pastor a church and say, let's turn with me into this text that's probably full of errors. You can't say, let's everybody read the Bible through each year that's probably full of errors. Doesn't work that way. The Bible talks about itself. It talks about it's pure. It's perfect. You know, Psalm 19, Psalm 119. It talks about the perfection of Scripture. And so, you know, Jesus said not one jot, one tittle is going to be lost till everything be fulfilled. So how do you square that with saying what it is you're just letting science and history and archaeology, secular, that is wrongly interpreted, influence the Scripture? And it's not going to hold water. You cannot just say the Bible's full of errors, but Jesus did rise from the dead. I say, well, you can't say that. Of course you can say that. You're not going anywhere with that. Because how do you live? Everybody will be chaos. Everybody will just do what's right in their own eyes. Everybody will just translate out of Scripture or say it wasn't supposed to be there. Anything that they personally don't like in the Bible, and it is just awful. It leads to confusion. And God is not the author of confusion. So get on your knees, let the Spirit of truth show you that God has preserved His Word, and that what one generation does in moderation, the next generation does in excess, and it always, that leaven, whether it's the Van Tilles, whether it's whoever, at Calvin, you know, now they got gays at Calvin College and all this, whatever it is, it will destroy the next generation. And that leaven will leaven even the lump of Pentecost, unless we expel it out, so to speak. God bless you. I love you. In Jesus' name, keep living for Jesus Christ.